Lord, we heard the Pharisees are plotting against you.
Remember the words that I spoke to you, that no servant is greater than his master. If they persecute me, they will persecute you. In this world, you will have tribulation, and you will be hated and reviled by all for my name's sake. But rejoice in that day, for great is your reward in heaven. Remember this, I will never leave you or forsake you, but I'll be with you always.
But he'll wrap. you're going to be able to walk in, you kind of acknowledge this, but turn this thing to the camera. So you want me to look in the camera?
I'm concerned that there's been an erroneous theology in America, that somehow we have thought that we are the healthy and the whole church, and that if there are brothers and sisters suffering around the world, maybe they've done something wrong.
Yeah, we did.
And hopefully they can get to a place where they can be like us. And it's backwards.
I was in the Central Highlands of Vietnam, and someone remarked about how much the Christians suffer there, and one Vietnamese Christian remarked, suffering is not the worst thing that can happen to us. Disobedience to God is the worst thing.
Tom, you're lifting him up, putting your hand on his head, on his neck, or getting ready to embrace.
When Voice of the Martyrs came to me and said, we just like to tell you what we're all about and want to see if we could partner in doing something to help the world see that there's a persecuted church out there. About a month later, I went through and I'm still kind of walking through a personal crisis. And this will be the first painting that I've done in the last 6 months. I've canceled all the others, but this one has so gripped my heart that every time I pick up the phone to cancel, God said, don't do that.
I think of us often as the Church of Laodicea, but we would say of ourselves, we're wealthy, we don't need anything. And the Lord would say, no, on the contrary, you're pitiful, poor, you're blind. And there has to be an undoing of that wrong theology and an understanding again of the place of suffering to each believer in Jesus Christ.
There are stories of heroes, shining stories in the midst of what we would call filth, where the glory of God shines in cells today, not just with Paul and Silas, but today.
You'd be a little bit more bent over like this, and it would just be like,
I love it.
Obviously, what I'm doing is a metaphor. I don't know what an angel looks like. I don't know what wings look like. I don't know what Christ will be robed in, but I'm doing all I can to metaphorically impart that this is a homecoming. This is, you know, home free for somebody who has followed in the footsteps of the Master.
My desire in this is certainly to let Christians in this part of the world know about their brothers and sisters who are suffering and open our eyes to see it as part and parcel of the privilege of following Christ.
This Martyrs Museum are some of the objects that were shown. Most of them, if not over half, were actually taken like from the ashes of a church in Nigeria. The dagger there was taken from a village in Kano where dozens of churches have been burned down. The pages from Tyndale's Bible. These represent Christians today and Christians over the centuries who were victorious, who were overcomers. Some people say we can't tell our families or our children or our friends about these things. They're too depressing. But actually, they're some of the most victorious elements we have.
This is not the way God chose for me to follow, you know, but it's the way He chose for somebody to follow. And this is happening on a daily basis. And this martyr is now standing for the Lord who he has followed in the footsteps of. This is not a depressed occasion.
Paul said in the Philippians, for it has been granted to you, gifted to you on behalf of Christ, not only to believe on him, but also to suffer for him.
I was in a village in Kano, Peru, where 17 houses had been burned of the Christians. The pastor had been killed the night before. His body was there on the floor under a blanket with some candles around it. And the people had no more church, no more pastor, no more houses. And at the time we arrived in the village, there were about 30 of them standing in the muddy street having their song service. Upon leaving that village, they gave me a tapestry that said, that talks about the revelations, be faithful unto death and I'll give you a crown of life.
We have a responsibility to wake up and to say, I get you, Lord, when you say precious in your sight is the death of your saints. And if it's precious in God's sight, we better follow in His steps and make it precious in our sight.
I know you're shaken, a loved one taken. Oh, but hear me, come draw near me, their pain is passing now, they rest at last now, safely home. They are strong.
The seed.